will discuss about physical quantities and measurements. What is physical quantity? Physical quantity is a quantity that can be measured. Now, what is measurement? Measurement is the comparison of an unknown quantity with a known fixed quantity of same type. Now, the known fixed quantity of same type is known as the unit. Every physical quantity has many units. Now, the unit which is accepted by all the scientists all over the world is known as the standard unit or standard international unit or SI unit. Now, in this chapter, we will discuss about few physical quantities and their SI units. First, we will discuss about length. What is length? Length is the distance between any two points. The SI unit of length is meter. Okay, now the multiples of meter are kilometer, hectometer, etc., and the sub multiples are centimeter, millimeter, etc. Now we use a measuring scale or measuring tape for measurement of length. See here, we have a measuring scale. In one side we have centimeter scale and the other side we have inches. Here I will measure the length of this piece of wood by using the measuring scale. See, we hold one end of the piece of wood at 0 cm and see that the other end is ending at 15 cm. Therefore, the length of this piece of wool is 15 cm. Similarly, we can use measuring tape also for measurement of length of any object. Now, we will discuss about mass. What is mass? Mass is the amount of matter contained in an object, and the SI unit of mass is kilogram. The SI unit of mass is kilogram. Gram, centigram, milligram, these are the submultiples of kilogram, and metric ton and quintal are the multiples of kilogram. Now we use beam balance or physical balance for the measurement of mass. You must have seen a beam balance in a grocer shop. Right now I am not having any beam balance, so I am showing you the diagram of the beam balance. This is how a beam balance look like. Okay. Now we will discuss about time. What is time? Time is the interval between any two events. Now, what is the SI unit of time? The SI unit of time is second. The bigger units of second are minutes, hours, years, days, months, etc. And the smaller units are millisecond, microsecond, etc. Okay? Now, we can use a wristwatch, a wall clock, a table clock, a stopwatch, anything for measurement of time. Here we have this table clock. We see that according to the hour position of hour hand and minute hand, the time is 1 p.m. right now. Okay? Now, we will discuss about temperature. What is temperature? Temperature is the degree of hotness or coldness of a body. Now, what is the SI unit of temperature? The SI unit of temperature is Kelvin, and the other units are Celsius and Fahrenheit. Now, we use thermometer for measuring temperature. At home, we use clinical thermometer for measuring the temperature of a human being. Now, using clinical thermometer, we can measure from 35 degrees Celsius to 42 degrees Celsius. And mercury is used as the thermometric liquid in a clinical thermometer. And for measuring the temperature of any object in a laboratory, we use laboratory thermometer. And generally, alcohol is used as the thermometric liquid in a laboratory thermometer. Okay? Now, through laboratory thermometer, we can measure generally from minus 10 degrees Celsius to 110 degrees Celsius. Nowadays, we use digital thermometer also at home, but in digital thermometer we don't use any thermometric liquid. Okay. Now we will discuss about volume. what is volume? Volume is the space occupied by an object. Now, what is the SI unit of volume? The SI unit of volume is cubic meter. Okay? Now, there are some other units also, like the smaller units are cubic centimeter, cubic millimeter, etc. And there are bigger units also. Okay? Now, see here, we have two balls. Here I have a big ball and a small ball. Naturally, the big ball is occupying more space and the small ball is occupying less space. So, as this is occupying more space, we can say that big ball is having more volume than this smaller ball. Okay? Now, for measurement of liquid, we use measuring cylinder, measuring beaker, pipette or burette. And what unit is used for measurement of volume of a liquid? We generally use milliliter, kiloliter, centiliter, liter, all these units for measurement of volume of a liquid. Now we have to know what is the relation between cubic centimeter and milliliter. See, we know that 1 cubic centimeter equals to 1 milliliter. Therefore, 1000 cubic centimeter must be equals to 1000 milliliter. Now we all know that 1000 milliliter means 1 liter. Okay? So we all have to remember this relation that 1000 cubic centimeter equals to 1 liter. So if we have to convert cubic centimeter into liter, we will use this formula. Okay? Now we will learn about the formulas of how to find out the volume of some 3D shapes. Suppose the first one we are talking about is cuboid. What will be the formula of volume of a cuboid? Cuboid has length, breadth and height. So the formula will be length multiplied by breadth multiplied by height. What will be the formula for volume of a cube? As cube has all its sides equal, therefore the volume of a cube will be side multiplied by side multiplied by side. What will be the volume of a cylinder? Volume of a cylinder is pi r square h, where pi is 22 by 7, r is the radius and h is the height of the cylinder. Now we will discuss the formula of volume of a cone. Now, the volume of a cone is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Here also the value of pi is 22 by 7. R is the radius and h is the height. Now, what will be the volume of the sphere? It is 4 by 3 pi r cube. As I told you, the value of pi is same, 22 by 7. R is the radius of the sphere. Okay, so here we have learned the formulas of finding out the volume of this particular 3D shapes. Okay, I hope this video will be helpful for you. Thank you. Hello students, in this video we will discuss about area, speed and density. What is area? Area is the surface occupied by an object. The SI unit of area is square meter. The multiples of this SI unit of area are square kilometer, hectare, hour, etc. And the submultiples are square centimeter, square millimeter, etc. Here, I have two mobile phones. You see, this white phone is occupying more surface and this black phone is occupying less surface on this board. So, from this we can conclude that the area of this white phone is more than the area of this black phone. Okay? Now, we will discuss about speed. What is speed? speed is the rate of change of distance with time. Now, the SI unit of speed is meter per second. It's meter per second. Now, how we find out speed? What will be the mathematical expression for speed? Let's see. If we need to find out speed, we write speed equals to distance by time. That means if we divide the distance covered by any object by the time taken by that object, we can find out the speed of that object. Now, as you have seen, the SI unit of speed is meter per second. We have to know how we can convert meter per second into kilometer per hour. Here, I am showing you 1 meter per second equals to 1 meter by 1 second. Now, we know that 1 meter means 1 by 1000 kilometer and 1 second means 1 by 3600 hours. 1 by 3600 hours. Now, according to this, if we do the division of fraction, we will get 3600 by 1000 kilometer per hour, and after cancellation we will get 18 by 5 kilometer per hour. Okay, so we can conclude from here that 1 meter per second equals to 18 by 5 kilometer per hour, and vice versa, that is 1 kilometer per hour equals to 5 by 18 meter per second. So, if we have numericals, and in these numericals we are told to convert meter per second into kilometer per hour, we will multiply by 18 by 5. And if we are told to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, we will multiply by 5 by 18. Okay? Now, let's discuss about density. What is density? Density is the mass per unit volume. What is the SI unit of density? The SI unit of density is meter. The SI unit of density is kilogram per cubic meter. It's kilogram per cubic meter. Okay? Now, it can be written in short form as kilogram per meter cube. Now, we will see what is the mathematical expression of density. As I told you, density equals to mass by volume. Okay? Now, if the volume remains same and we have two objects whose volumes are same but the masses are different, the object whose mass will be more, that object will have more density than the other object. Okay? Now, we will see the relation between kilogram per meter cube and gram per centimeter cube. Let's see. The CGS unit of density is gram per centimeter cube. Now, 1 gram per centimeter cube means 1 gram by 1 centimeter cube. Okay? Now, 1 gram means 1 by 1000 kilogram. And 1 centimeter means 1 centimeter cube means 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter. Now, what does it mean? 1 centimeter equals to 1 by 100 meter, 1 by 100 meter, and 1 by 100 meter. Because we know that 1 centimeter equals to 1 by 100 meter. Okay. So here we get this. Now I'm rubbing this, and I'll do the next part now. So 1 gram per centimeter cube equals to 100 into 100 into 100 by 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Now let's do the cancellation. If we cancel the zeros, we have 1 gram per centimeter cube equals to 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Okay, so if we have to convert gram centimeter cube into kilogram per meter cube, we will multiply it by 1000 and vice versa. Okay, I hope this video will be helpful for you.